Planet Dolan. From whether the moon is made of cheese to what would happen if a comet hit Earth, we answer 10 of your most burning questions about outer space.
Hello there, my name is Shima and I'll be reading out the questions and answers.
I'm Danger Dolan and I'm here to blow your mind with truth.
Why does the moon shine?
The moon has millions of people as an audience every night, and it likes to look pretty. So it cakes itself in shiny makeup and flutters its eyelashes, hoping to one day find a boy moon.
The shine we see is actually sunlight bouncing off the moon's surface, like a flashlight in a mirror. So the light of the moon is actually the light of the sun. Why do people think the moon is made of cheese?
Of course the moon is made of cheese. Only the richest and fanciest of people can afford moon cheese though. It's soft and super tasty, if a bit sandy.
Actually, most people don't think the moon is made of cheese, even though it looks like it's full of holes and blue with mold. Those holes are actually craters caused by asteroids, which are big chunks of rock and ice that fly through space. And the bluish color is caused by the Earth's shadow on the moon's surface. What is a blue moon?
It means the moon is angry at you, and now charging up its intergalactic laser death beam to blow up the Earth. What did it see you do? You ate all the ice cream without sharing it, didn't you?
The name blue moon actually has nothing to do with the moon's color. A blue moon is the second full moon in a month, though originally it was the fourth full moon in a season, like summer or winter. How do planets stay up in the sky?
Glue. Tons and tons of glue is pasted on outer space and the planets are pushed onto the glue really hard to hold them in place.
The planets in our solar system, including Earth, all spin around our sun. The reason why the planets do this is because of the sun's gravity, always pulling on the planets. But because the planets are moving so fast, they spin around the sun rather than falling into it. How many galaxies and stars are there in the universe?
We have an army of scientists and smart people standing in front of a huge telescope, slowly counting them one by one. The last time we heard from them, they claimed there are at least 26 stars in the universe, possibly 27.
A galaxy is a huge collection of stars that all spin around a center point, like a spinning top. In the part of the universe we can see, there are at least 100 billion galaxies. But there's a lot of the universe that we can't see that also has galaxies. That's a lot of stars! Does everything in the universe spin around our sun?
Yes, and this is because a penguin rides a bike around and around the center of the sun to keep things spinning. But it's such a tough job, and it gets so hot inside the sun that when his replacement comes along, he comes back to Earth and chills out on ice to catch his breath.
Not at all. Our galaxy, called the Milky Way Galaxy, spins like a flying disc and our sun is on one of the outer arms of it. Our whole galaxy is whizzing through the universe, along with many, many others. Why is our galaxy called the Milky Way Galaxy?
If you were to make the long journey to the center of the galaxy, you'd find a vault filled to the brim with Milky Way candy bars. But you can't have any. And that sucks, man.
A long, long time ago, people thought our galaxy looked like spilled milk across the sky. The Greeks used to call it Galaxias Kuklos, or Milky Band. And to the Romans, it was Via Lactea, or Road of Milk. Why is there no gravity in space?
We actually don't have enough gravity for both space and Earth. So a long time ago, people in suits decided to take away gravity from space, and then they made it all floaty. Mostly because nobody lives out there. Nobody at all.
There is gravity in space, it only feels like there isn't. Astronauts, spaceships, and other things in space are actually always falling due to gravity pulling on them. It's like when you're on a roller coaster and you get that funny feeling in your stomach. If there was no gravity, astronauts and their spaceships would fly off into space and wouldn't be able to come back. What would happen if a comet hit Earth?
This would be really bad, but luckily, modern advances in technology means we have solutions to prevent this from happening. We would roll out a giant trampoline and bounce it straight back out into space.
Comets have hit Earth before without making too much of a mess, but there are a few things that could happen. The comet could burn up in the sky, the comet could land in an ocean, The comet could hit land and knock down some trees, or might even hit a city. Or a really big comet could hit, smashing land, causing a giant tidal wave, or even causing tremors. How far is the closest black hole from Earth?
You know garbage trucks that visit your neighborhood, or garbage chutes you can tip your rubbish into? That's not a random ditch you're pouring it into. That's a black hole.
Astronomers, really smart scientists that study space, think that there's a black hole at the center of our galaxy. That's pretty close considering the size of the universe, but it's far enough away that we aren't in any danger of being sucked in by it.
So how about it? Do you have any burning questions about life and the universe that you would like us to answer in a future video? Go ahead and ask it in the comment box below. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a cool one! By the way, did you know that Super Planet Dolan has a Patreon page? The animators we have on board are crazy talented, and they're working full time to bring you a new animation every single week. But they need your support. By becoming a patron and pledging to fund these animators each month, you'll receive a variety of bonuses, such as high-resolution art from the animators themselves, early access to videos before anyone else, and even the opportunity to have your question answered on screen by your favorite characters, immortalized for the whole world to see. With enough support, we might even be able to bring on more animators, which means even more videos per week. You'll find links to the page down below.